And now, finally, we will learn how to write off uncollectible rent. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Sometimes tenants move out after becoming bankrupt or just in a condition where they simply can't pay. This means there's several months' rent owed that will never be collected. If you recorded the uncollectible invoices, then those invoices are adding to the balance of the rent receivable account. You could just delete them, but you shouldn't. You should keep a record of the months they stayed and what they owed. Sometimes the past invoices will have helpful information on them, and you can just make the tenant inactive so that you could reactivate the tenant if you ever need to see the details on anything that was written on one of their invoices. So what will happen when you write off an invoice? Well, rent receivable will go down because you're no longer owed that money because you wrote it off. And a normal accounting expense that accountants call bad debt expense will increase, and this is the expense that your company has when customers who owe you money don't pay. We will call this account uncollectible rent expense. So just like we learned before, we click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, then we go to the top right and click New. Now, of course, the account type is expense, and the detail type usually doesn't matter, but they have one special for us, bad debts. And instead of naming it bad debts, we're going to name it uncollectible rent expense. Okay, save and close. Now we're able to do an example. Now, let's imagine on August 15th, you determine that Dave Deeney will never pay. Well, the bad news is that only the desktop accountant's edition of QuickBooks has the write-off invoices tool. So unfortunately, you will have to make a journal entry to account for this. And you may well ask, how much money will the journal entry be? Well, obviously, it'll be the amount of Dave's balance because that's what we're writing off our books. If we click Reports and we click Tenant Balance Detail, we can see that Dave's balance, the money amount that we will never get, is $3,155. So that has to be brought down to zero with the proper transaction. We click the plus sign, and then three choices below Other, we click Journal Entry. Now, we made this determination on August 15th of 2019. And click to bring the account, click the pull down arrow. The first account we're going to put is the one we just put on the list, uncollectible rent expense. And in accounting, when we record an expense, we always debit the expense. So Dave's balance was $3,155. Push the tab key. Keep pushing until it goes to the next row. Now, the account on the next row will also be $3,155, but that will be removing his balance from unearned rental income. Even though Dave had a positive balance and owed us money, his balance in the individual customer records are reflected in the unearned rental income account. So we click here, and then the computer knows to balance this out, we need $3,155 as a credit. But there's one very important last step. On the same row as the unearned rental income account, where it says name, you must choose the name Dave Deeney. That's what tells QuickBooks It's not just any customer's balance. It's specifically Dave Deeney, going down by $3,155 because his rent is uncollectible. When we click Save and Close, we can see that Dave's balance has been brought, well, we didn't really refresh this report. Oh yeah, we did, okay. Dave Deeney, here it is. Dave Deeney, this is his balance, and here's the journal entry we just made, bringing his balance down to zero. And if we click Reports, and then we click Trial Balance, you can see that uncollectible rent expense shows up for the first time in the trial balance as $3,155.